Hi, Unison is a compiler tool that performs register allocation and instruction scheduling in integration. The key advantage over traditional compilers is that we can obtain optimal assembly code. In this demo, I will show how Unison works in further detail. To do that, we will go through the generation of assembly code for the iterative version of Factorial, which is like the hello world of compilers. Notice that Factorial has three main blocks. The initialization with the definition and assignment of f, the while loop where the computed result is multiplied, and the return block. The processor for which we are going to generate code is Hexagon, a very long instruction word digital signal processor that is present in many mobile devices. After parsing, optimizing, and selecting processor instructions, let's look at how the actual input to Unison looks like. This is it. A control flow graph with the three basic blocks that I mentioned before in a static single assignment form. This program representation is very close, for example, to that of LLVM after instruction selection. Notice that the instructions belong to the instruction set of Hexagon, for example ADD, which performs an addition with an immediate, or MPYI, which performs a multiplication. When we want to generate optimal code, all possible combinations of register allocation and instruction scheduling decisions must be considered. Even if Factorial is a small function, this number is huge. Let's see what happens if we just try to explore the space of all possible combinations with a naive solver. The exploration of these combinations forms a tree, which we call the search tree. Here, we can see that a brute force strategy doesn't work, even for a tiny function such as Factorial. Let's stop the search. We got a huge search tree with tens of thousands of combinations of decisions explored, but could not find a single solution. Okay, so clearly we are in need of better solving techniques. Among other things, Unison uses constraint-solving techniques to discard partial combinations of decisions that cannot lead to solutions. Let's take a look at the search tree when constraint-solving is applied. Yes, this looks way better. In only 9 search nodes, we have found the optimal solution to Factorial, that is the orange diamond. Let's take a closer look to the solving process. Close to each node, we can see now which decisions the solver is trying out. The first decision is to fix the estimated number of execution cycles to 271, then to discard some optional instructions that are not needed for spilling or life range splitting, and finally to assign some temporaries to specific registers. The constraint solver is smart enough to infer during the process that all remaining register allocation and instruction scheduling decisions follow from this. And not only that, after finding the solution, it actually proves that there is no better one. Let's take a look at the solution we found. This is the data flow of the solution, with instructions represented by boxes and connected by temporaries. We can see that the solver has only introduced one additional instruction. This instruction is the light green box in the return block, labeled as TFR. This is a register-to-register move instruction which copies the factorial result to another register before returning. Later, we'll see how this makes a difference in the solution. This is the register assignment of each basic block. Here, each column represents a register, each row represents a cycle, and each rectangle represents the life range of a temporary. And this is the final schedule. Here, each column represents an instruction and the horizontal bars correspond to issue cycles. Hexagon is a very long instruction processor, so multiple instructions can be issued in the same cycle. Here, we can see, for example, that 3 instructions are issued in parallel in the initialization basic block. Okay, so Unison found the optimal assembly code for Factorial. How does that compare to a regular compiler such as LLVM? To the left, we have the Hexagon code generated by Unison, and to the right the code generated by LLVM version 3.5, with initialization, loop and return blocks. If we compare the code, we can see that Unison's initialization block, that is, this one, takes one cycle, while LLVM's initialization block, that is, this one, takes two. So even in a tiny function such as factorial, Unison manages to generate code slightly faster. And the key is that Unison reasons about register allocation and instruction scheduling simultaneously. In this case, we have two variables, the n and f in factorial, with overlapping life ranges, and both of them must be assigned to register 0, due to the calling convention of Hexagon. This means that one of them must be copied at some point to another register to preserve the semantics of the function. The key difference is when and where this copy is done. To see more clearly what's going on, let's take a look at the register assignment of the variables n and f cycle by cycle as done by Unison and LLVM. Unison preserves the variable n in register 0 during the entire function, and the variable f in register 1 almost until the end, when it moves it to register 0. LLVM moves directly n to register 1, and later to register 2, and keeps f in register 0. Considering register allocation only, it is hard to tell which decision is better. However, because Unison reasons about scheduling at the same time, it can see that moving f from register 1 to register 0 at the end has no cost, because it can be done in parallel with another instruction. On the other hand, LLVM realizes later during scheduling that moving n from register 0 to register 1 takes one additional cycle, but then it's too late to reconsider the decision. Here we can see again how the register to register copy of Unison, that is, this one, can be packed into the return block without additional cost, while the register to register copy of LLVM, that is, this one, requires an extra cycle in the initialization block. To convince you that Unison can be practical and not just solve tiny functions such as factorial, I will demonstrate the tool for a more realistic example, a signal processing algorithm from media bench that is more representative of the kind of code that runs in a processor like Hexagon. This is the input to Unison. We can see that the function has a more realistic size, with 11 basic blocks and more than 100 instructions. One of the key features in Unison to scale to larger functions like this is that it can run in iterations. The more iterations it runs, the better the solution it gets, and eventually the optimal solution is obtained if we are patient enough. First, there is a short pre-solving phase which makes the problem easier to solve. After a couple of failed iterations, a first solution is found. Then, the next iteration finds a better solution. And after that, the subsequent iterations do not manage to find anything better. In this example, we have aborted the solver after 10 iterations. If we wanted the optimal solution, we could be waiting for hours, unfortunately. On the positive side, the solution that Unison found already improves the quality of the corresponding LLVM code by more than 10%, which is seen here. Another interesting piece of information given by the solver is a proof that, even if we did not find the optimal solution, the solution we found is less than 1% away from the optimal, which is seen here. And this is probably good enough in most practical cases. Like we did with factorial, let's compare Unison and LLVM for this function. This code is harder to analyze, however, we can see that some basic blocks in Unison take less execution cycles than their counterparts in LLVM. For example, basic block 3 takes 3 cycles for Unison and 4 cycles for LLVM. Basic block 7 takes 14 cycles for Unison and 16 cycles for LLVM. That's it. I hope that the demo convinced you that Unison can be practical and more effective than traditional compilers. If you want to know more about the Unison project, please read our papers on the topic, which are available in our websites. Goodbye!